Welcome to the Great Exodus Series, God's plan for your rescue. Come out of Babylon and come out of the world. Let my people go. Sorry, the path to Mount Zion. Today's topic for Friday is about complacency. It is about who said that taking up your cross would be easy? Who said that it's not combined with action and work? Have you not seen the example of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ Himself, that every day He went forth to the lost sheep, every day He assisted the poor, every day He lifted up the needy, every day He raised the dead, and every day He healed the sick. He was doing righteous deeds for the Father every day. Why? Because He was filled with the love of the Father, and because He brought the love of the Father to the nations, because He knew when He will show that love to the people, something will change this world. And it did. After He ascended, the apostles went into the nations and they created a multitude of people ready for the harvest. And in the same pattern, it's now our time. The escape of the bride is at hand. The ascension of the first fruit is at hand. They will disappear. They will escape. Latest by next month. And then we who are left behind as the apostles and disciples will have to take our cross and will do the righteous work that the Lord has done before us. We have to go into the nation and to gather the people with the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, in love, unity and support at the new but restored altar. Gather them together for the great harvest of the ages that will take place at the base of Mount Zion. It is your time now to walk with us together. And I call especially the women. It's your time, the time of the women warriors. Come out of your hiding places. Step into the open. Stand strong against all false doctrines. And bring forth all of your women traits. Love, compassion, unity, building of family, gathering the chicks. All this you will bring in. I know that most of the societies of the Rose that we will establish in the nation in the next 6 years will be led by women. But many members will be women. I think around 70% to 80% will be women, because they will understand that it's their time. It is the time of the Holy Spirit. It's the time of the women now to gather in the harvest. The time of Ruth, the time of other women in the Bible who were not only prophets but also led house churches in the book of Acts. Now it's your time to rise up. Now it's your time to come together. Listen to me. Come and join Triple Grace. Walk with us in the great Exodus. Come out of the world and out of Babylon. Share your resources. Support one another. Lift up the needy. Rescue your children and the children of the Father towards Mount Zion. This is a straight path that will lead you to paradise. You are called forth now. It is your time, as it was the time for Mary Magdalene at the tomb after the resurrection to be the first one to see Jesus Christ. Now it's your time to be the first one on the path. I call all the women forth. Join me. Walk with me. Take my hand and walk that path. You are called forth to glory. You are called forth to bring as many people to righteousness as possible. It is your time. Become a member of Triple Grace. The link for the website is down below. Help us to bring forth the societies of the Rose in the nation, that we can establish them in all countries, in all towns. Support us. with your gift, with your acts of loving kindness. If you want to make a donation, the information is in the description box below. Help us to bring it forth. Be the mother of many. As Mary Magdalene was the mother of many, now you are called for us also to be the mother of many. Gather them together. It's your calling, your destiny, your purpose here on earth. If you have questions, send them to me at triplegrace55@gmail.com. But be part of the movement of the Great Exodus, God's plan of rescue. He will put you under his wings of protection. Do not worry, if calamity will strike, we will be protected. He has promised it to us. We will tell Satan, let my people go. And we will take the pearls from the dragon's lairs and bring them to the Holy Father. Bring them to Mount Zion, the dwelling place of the Father. The mountain that's not carved by human hands. The mountain that is carved by the hand of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Walk with us, that path, the special path, the narrow path, the only righteous path towards the light. And be part of the great rapture of the ages. Go to paradise and be with the Father and his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, forever and ever. I love you all dearly, but you must understand that nowhere it is written that taking up your cross would be comfortable or easy. It is hard work. It is a continuous striving to be perfect. And it is a continuous repentance and a continuous doing righteous deeds. You cannot sit in your complacency under a false grace doctrine, as many, most people do. Many churches proclaim that nowadays. It is your heart that will be judged at the end. And if your heart is filled with love for others, with a Lazarus at your gate, with the nameless, the faceless, the needy, then you are filled with the righteous deeds of the saints. And then when you will act every day in a daily sacrifice of love, you will be qualified to be raptured into paradise. So walk with me. Come out of the world and out of Babylon, onto that path, into righteousness, and become an example of the power and the glory of the Father for all people to see. Let your light shine into the nations. Thank you that you are here with me and listening to this teaching about the Great Exodus. Every day we put up another topic, so please follow us. Sign up at Triple Grace. I'm a member. Sign up for the newsletter. Be a patron for Triple Grace at Patreon. Have a look at our YouTube channel and watch all the videos that we provide, not only the daily prophetic words. There's a great teaching there for you, and it will assist you to walk that narrow path. Thank you that you're here with me today. My name is Michael. May God bless you and your family abundantly, and I will see you again tomorrow. Maranatha.